So what I want to recommend is actually not a piece, but it's our radio show, which is presented by our managing editor, Boima Tucker. It's been there for ages, and it actually feels pretty nice to have the opportunity to promote it on here. I think everyone should check it out. This episode is really, really fascinating. It has Sean on it. It has Dylan Valley, who you're all going to see in a moment, on it as well. And basically, what it is it's a musical as well as an historical tour of Cape Town as a city. And I mean, I just want to commend Dylan and Sean. You guys have exceptional music taste. And I was glad that I was able to get an insight into your musical influences. And the episode is just put together really well. It has some interviews with snippets with Valmont Lane, and it's just awesome. Check it out. But I think one thing I wanted to reflect on quickly, which I think pertains to this episode, is that when I listened to it, I became just sort of reacquainted with just how remarkable cultural production was during apartheid, which is this thing of how, despite all of the tremendous constraints that people faced, all of the tremendous hardship that people faced, they were still able to produce music that somehow was able to synthesize this tension between the local and the international, between having to be modern as well as still drawing from traditional roots. And I think above all, managing to be popular. It was all mass culture at the time, but despite it being mass culture, it still had this emancipatory content. And just being reacquainted with all of that music from that time, I think had me thinking about the show that we're going to do today. And you know, one danger that I always try to guard against is trying to romanticize the apartheid era, to sort of fall into that trap of thinking, you know, ever since then, we just haven't had music like they made it back then. We haven't had cinema like they made it back then. And trying to just, understand what it was that made it the case that music was able to be this powerful social force that was political, but at the same time also deeply cultural and personal for a lot of people. So I think everyone should check out that episode. And I think it's an incredible radio show. And kudos to Boima for always being on top of his game with that, and for Sean and Dylan's input. So that's what I want to highlight this week.
So I was going to... Great summary there, Will. In the first minute, I think the first 2 or 3 minutes of the program, it's like the Adhan. So it's like somebody, the call to prayer. Guma music, which is a sort of local form. So like that's like literally in the first 2 or 3 minutes. Oh, not Guma. It was actually what people in South Africa call, in Cape Town, called Nachtruppe, which means like night troops, people who sing. These are mostly like Muslim groups wearing suits, and they sing these like quaint Dutch songs. And this is like the opening, like 3-4 minutes of this program.
Exactly.
So I definitely recommend the program. I'm going to reciprocate the thing I'd like to recommend. Will wrote, this is, I don't know, somebody watching now is just like, yo, these people, can they mention other people's articles? It's about the school system in South Africa, and it's entitled What is Learning For? And it is written to coincide with the release of what they call in South Africa matric results, which is like the senior year of high school. This is like your the big exam that you write at for the last exam, to whether or not you qualify to go to university or whether you just get a pass that allows you to get to a technical college, etc. And what Will actually explores in the article is the differences between a private education in South Africa, where the passing rate is really high, and the rate for public schools, which, by the way, where the majority of the students in South Africa goes to school. And it's an exploration of kind of critiquing what's happened to education, particularly public education in South Africa. And as a result, it's also a critique of sort of post-apartheid society. And it's really nicely written. It's a very much a polemical piece. I can recommend it full-heartedly. So here's a reminder to hit and like the subscribe button on YouTube, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And please subscribe to our Patreon, where you can access all of the episodes from this program. And you can also help us fund Africa as a Country in general.